Vanessa. In this teacher video guide, we'll introduce you to the Mindset series of lessons called Evaluating and Comparing Texts. We'll tell you what the series of lessons is about and how it links to the curriculum. We'll also discuss ideas for using the lessons with your learners. In this series, we discuss how people are bombarded by texts and how they need to be able to evaluate and compare these texts to be aware of exactly what they are being exposed to. We also see that while texts may cover similar subjects, they will differ depending on their target audience, format, and purpose. In this series of lessons, we revise some of the terminology that your learners will need to know when examining texts such as register, diction, and tone. And then we practice analyzing texts to see how these elements influence the message that is conveyed. There are 8 lessons in this series. Features of texts, more on features of texts, comparing texts, more on comparing texts, different texts for different functions, more on different texts for different functions, same topic, different approach, comparing texts. The lessons in this series all address learning outcome 2, reading and viewing. They will help learners to achieve a range of assessment standards, including being able to explore and explain key features of texts and how they contribute to meaning, identify and explain the purpose, structure, and language use in texts. Before the start of each lesson, we will state the outcome and assessment standards that are addressed in the lesson. And in most lessons and in the lesson notes, we will give the lesson outcomes for each lesson. In the past, reading lessons ensured that learners were able to understand the meaning of texts, but little attention was paid to thinking critically about what they read. The new curriculum places a strong emphasis on the ability to think critically, and these lessons develop critical reading skills by encouraging learners to engage with texts. In this series of lessons, we look at how one topic can be written about in many different ways, depending on the attitude of the writer, the type of text, and the purpose which it serves. We analyze a range of texts, including a gossip column, a cartoon, an editorial, a lifestyle article, and an opinion piece. In each case, learners are encouraged to note the differences in style, tone, register, diction, and format, depending on the type of text. Through using a range of examples, we reinforce the vocabulary needed to describe texts, and we establish questions and techniques that can be applied to other texts. This will help learners to develop confidence in their ability to evaluate and compare texts and will ensure that they are able to apply what they have learned in these lessons to other texts. The texts that we have sourced as examples in these lessons all come from the Sunday Times. Because newspapers make wonderful resource in the English classroom, it would be a good idea to keep a pile of newspapers available in your classroom. You could use these newspapers to set more activities to encourage your learners to practice the skills and techniques developed in these lessons using other texts. If you are able to, you will find it useful to watch the videos by yourself before you show them to your learners. This will help you to see how to incorporate the video lessons into your learning program and can help you plan tasks, activities, and discussions to take place before, during, or after viewing the video. If you can't watch the video in advance, this teacher video guide and the print support materials will give you some suggestions for using the videos as well as a sense of what each lesson covers. The print support materials and most video lessons include a task for learners at the end of the lesson. These tasks will help keep the learners involved in the lesson and will also enable you to assess that they are working towards the outcomes and assessment standards of the lessons. You may also want to set additional tasks or longer assignments based on the whole series, which could be used to track learners' progress towards the outcomes. Now, let's have a more detailed look at the lessons in the series and how you can use them in the classroom. In the first two lessons, we focus on features of texts. In the lessons, we examine newspaper columns and guide learners to read between the lines of the texts. We define and practice commenting on the style, tone, register, and diction that have been used. To extend these lessons, you could ask learners to find examples of a variety of styles in different sections of the newspaper. Lessons 3 and 4 teach strategies for comparing texts. In these two lessons, we look at a range of texts that were created when South African motorists were required to convert their driver's license. We compare how a political cartoon, a news article, an editorial, and a lifestyle article all refer to the same event but cover it in different ways depending on the type of text being produced and the purpose which it serves. After your learners have watched these lessons, you may want to use a recent news event to complete a similar activity of comparing texts that are on the same topic. In lessons 5 and 6, we learn that different texts are used for different functions. In these lessons, we learn how to be more critical readers by asking a range of questions about a text. We use these questions to closely examine newspaper articles and ask questions about them in order to determine how the text is working in terms of diction, register, style, and intention. As with all the lessons in this series, it would be helpful if learners were provided with additional texts to examine in the same way as the newspaper articles we analyzed in the lessons. This will reinforce the terminology and techniques that were taught in the lessons and will show learners that they can be used to analyze any text. In lessons 7 and 8, we see how texts can cover the same topic but take a different approach, and we compare texts on the same subject. In these lessons, we compare a range of texts that all discuss child support grants. The examples that are shown will reinforce earlier lessons and will once again show learners that the content and style of a text will be determined by the type of text that it is and the intention of the text. Again, you may want to source texts that all cover a topic that your learners will be interested in, or you could set them a task that involves finding and comparing a range of texts on a topic such as preventing HIV/AIDS. We hope that you will enjoy using these lessons to encourage learners to evaluate and compare texts. For more details about these lessons, please refer to our print teacher support materials and the lesson notes for each lesson. You can find these on our website, www.mindset.co.za.